communication between artists and the viewer, and between the works of art themselves. The studio is a laboratory, not a factory. An exhibition is the result of your experiments, but the process is never ending. If there is no annual exhibition in our school, there won't be any opportunity for our young and dynamic children to uphold the pride of the institution, to express their hidden talents, and to show what we were, what we are, and what we will be in this institution. Therefore, I, Urvi Vagya of Standard 10, your host for today's event, heartily welcome all the wonderful people present here. I welcome all our esteemed guests, dear teachers, parents, and my fellow friends. Seems like a dream has come true as we wake up to celebrate the annual exhibition after a wait of many years. So here we are, the students of GSMS, welcoming you to witness a magnificent and glorious annual exhibition, Melange, for the academic year 2024-25. At GSMS, we organize the annual exhibition to provide our students a platform to display their talents which cannot be exhibited in a classroom during the regular course of studies. GSMS believes in the strong relationship between academics and co-curricular activities which are required in building up a strong personality and an unshakable character of the student. Life is a symbol of brightness and prosperity. So let's commence our event by lighting the lamp of knowledge and wisdom, which is a symbolic moment that signifies the dispelling of darkness and igniting of thoughts and enlightenment. I would like to escort our distinguished guests for today for lighting the lamp that symbolizes the auspicious beginning of the program.
Ganesha, invoke his blessings upon us. Critical thinking, researching, and beyond all, the fun and the enjoyment in the process. By visiting these exhibits, the students develop confidence and a sense of pride in their abilities. This year's exhibition, as you all can see, titled Melange, has given a theme to each standard according to their cognitive abilities. EVS History, Math, Science, Literature, Games, all will come alive in the classrooms. We promise you a lot of fun and entertainment in the next 2 days. As we proceed with the inaugural program, you will witness glimpses of all these themes. Undoubtedly, long hours of practice of work by students have teachers have gone into making this a grand event. I once again thank our management, Prashantji, and all the trustees for your constant motivation and support for all the events of our school. I thank the heads and teachers of various institutions who are present here today. Your presence has made this event a memorable one. I thank the non-teaching staff, our housekeeping staff, and for their support in each and every step. Dear audience, such an event cannot happen without the dedication and commitment of teachers and students. All the teachers have collaborated very effectively to put up exemplary work that you will witness as you move towards the classrooms. The formal vote of thanks will follow, but I must make a special mention to the art department, Ms. Daljeet Sehra and Mr. Ramesh Kadam, and their student volunteers for their outstanding creation. Please give them a loud round of applause. In conclusion, as we enter into one more year of all-round excellence, we at Gopal Sharma Memorial School have set higher goals and dreams for ourselves and a brighter future for our students and all around us. Thank you and God bless.
I request our principal, Mrs. Sudha Sharin, to please felicitate our trustee, Mr. Prashant Sharma. Thank you, ma'am.
To kindly felicitate Mrs. Dr. Gulgadi Ali, who is currently the Director of Academics with Vanita Mishra's School. Thank you very much, Gul ma'am, for gracing this occasion. Your presence means a lot to us. I also request Prashantji to kindly felicitate Mrs. Shirley Pillai, Principal of our English School. Dr. Sunny Matthew, Principal of our ICSE section. Sir, please be honest. I now request our coordinators to please come forward and felicitate. I request Ms.
Thank you. song has set the tone for today. I hope everyone can feel the ambience of this splendid start. Thank you, students. It was a melodious performance. Audience, give them a loud round of applause. Now, I would like to call upon Urvi Bhavya.
Thank you, Vanshika. The preparation for this exhibition went on for a fortnight. The students and the teachers have researched endlessly with information to put up with this remarkable event. During the preparation, the students and the teachers interacted informally, which led to a better understanding among both, fostering a feeling of cooperation amongst the students and the teachers. Presenting before you the frantic and hectic behind-the-scenes activities which led to this grand finale.
Captures the spirit of our school exhibition. It is a testament to the dedication, creativity, and teamwork that our students and teachers have invested in making this event a success. The journey began months ago with meticulous planning. Teachers guided the students, helping to transform their ideas into reality through brainstorming sessions, organizing materials, and refining every detail. The vision for the exhibition slowly took shape. This wasn't just an exercise in academics. It was an opportunity to foster creativity, critical thinking, and collaboration. Our students embraced this challenge with enthusiasm. They approached their projects as opportunities to explore subjects that fascinated them. Conducting research, engaging in discussions, and overcoming obstacles. The process of refining their ideas required them to dig deeper, not only into the subjects, but into their own potential. This was a period of self-discovery, where students learned not just about the world around them, but also about their own interests and abilities. Each student brought a unique perspective to their project, resulting in a diverse array of exhibits. From scientific models to artistic displays, the variety showcased the individual talents and interests of our student body. But what made these projects truly special was the personal connection each student had with their work. Whether it was a model demonstrating a scientific principle or an art piece expressing a personal belief, every project had a story behind it. A story that reflected the student's journey of learning. The journey was not without its challenges. Moments of frustration were met with resilience and creativity. Both teachers and students worked together to overcome obstacles, rethinking strategies and supporting one another. This period of problem solving and collaboration was crucial. It taught our students that success isn't just about having great results, it's about being able to adapt, to push through difficulties, and to keep moving forward even when the path isn't clear. As the exhibition day approached, excitement filled the school. The hallways buzzed with activity as students rehearsed their presentations and fine-tuned their displays. The sense of camaraderie and shared purpose brought everyone together. It was heartwarming to see students helping one another, offering advice and sharing resources. This spirit of cooperation transformed the exhibition into a community effort where everyone's success was celebrated. But beyond the impressive exhibits, the true highlight was the spirit of collaboration and determination that made it all possible. This exhibition was not just about individual achievements, but about what can be accomplished when we work together. The teamwork displayed was a testament to the power of collective effort, proving that when we come together with a shared goal, there is nothing we cannot achieve. This exhibition is a shining example of what can be achieved through collaboration and hard work. It is a result of the unwavering commitment of our teachers and the boundless energy of our students. The exhibition is more than just a showcase of projects. It is a celebration of the learning journey, of the challenges overcome, and of the growth experienced by every participant. We hope that everyone who visits the exhibition will appreciate the hard work and creativity that went into the making of it. More importantly, we hope they leave feeling inspired by what we can achieve when we work together, overcome challenges, and strive for success. The lessons learned here extend far beyond the classroom, teaching our students valuable skills that will serve them well in all areas of life. Let this exhibition serve as a reminder that the pursuit of knowledge and creativity is a lifelong journey, one that is enriched by the contributions of every individual in our school community.
Thank you, audience, for your warm response. I hope all of you have enjoyed watching this PPT that has embarked the journey of our preparation.
Thank you, Urvi. In a society that worships love, freedom, and beauty, dance is sacred. It is a prayer for the future and a remembrance of the past. Dance is the hidden language of a soul. As per the topics of the respective classes, an extended version of their theme will be showcased in the form of a dance to enhance the ideas for better understanding and entertainment. Jagat jar yashatha marg asel, tar tomi shodhin, ani nasel, tar mag swandaha nirman kare. As said by Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, the meaning of this is, for any success, if there is a way, I will find it. If there is no way, I will make it. Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj's bravery, courage and intelligence truly proves how important he is in Indian history. The theme of Senate 5th is Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, the iconic king, and they will depict the valor of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj through the warrior dance. imagine our lives without our cooks, gardeners, house help, doctors, teachers, firemen, etc., etc. They are our lifeline. Our daily tasks would not be accomplished without them. So here we have our tiny tots of Standard First, who will be showcasing the theme of community helpers and will present the indispensables, which gives a tribute to our community helpers and appreciates their dedication and hard work.
The India is a land of festivals and fairs. Every 15 days, a festival is celebrated in some part of our country. However, there are certain festivals which are not known or less popular than some. The students of Standard 2nd will be performing the lesser known festivals of India, presenting the Mangala Gaur and then the hymns. The Mangala Gaur is celebrated on all Tuesdays in the Hindu calendar of Shravan, who is also as popular as Gauri and the consort of Lord Shiva.
Thank you.
It is celebrated to commemorate the birthday of Lord Padmasan Bhava, who is held in high reverence in Tibetan history. Now, the students will perform the hymns.
Thank you.
Thank you, Anwar. Today, as we speak about women empowerment, we know that women are about half the population in the world. Even with such an acute understanding and knowledge, the sad reality prevails. In India, women are worshipped in the form of Shakti and Devi. Yet, despite this, the recent gruesome happenings all across India should not go unheard. Girls, women and toddlers are not spared. A change will only be made if a change is made in your mindset. Teaching girls self-defense is important, but educating and teaching boys how to treat girls with respect is a lot more crucial. Presenting before you the daily struggles of women in the form of a dance drama performed by Standard 7th, who have been given the theme of women empowerment.
हिम्मत कमजोर नहीं थी, शक्ति का नाम ही आई। हिम्मत कर जीतेगी तू, खुद का किससे हारी है।
A loud round of applause. Moving away from women empowerment, we, the students of GSMS, are also taught about the importance of saving the environment and the ecology. The students of Standard 10th will perform a street play on the importance of saving water. Countries. Please do not forget to visit the classrooms as well. Thank you, audience, for being a great sport today. See you all tomorrow for day two of our grand celebration. I will now be starting with a vote of thanks. I stand here today to express my heartfelt thanks to parents. Please be seated. Parents, please be seated. I will now be starting with a vote of thanks. I stand here today to express my heartfelt thanks to all those who have made this event possible. I would like to start by thanking our Managing Trustee, Mr. Prashant Sharma Ji, and trustees who have always been supportive of our initiatives and encouraged us to strive for excellence. I express my gratitude to our esteemed guests and heads of various institutions for taking their precious time out of their hectic schedules to be present here today. My special thanks to our beloved principal, Mrs. Sudha Sharan, for conceptualizing this event for the GSMS family. Thank you to our coordinators, Mrs. Chitra Menon, Mrs. Rachna Kapoor, and Mrs. Ruma Patil, for their timeless efforts and hard work. A big thank you to our dance teacher, Mrs. Preeti Vaidya, and music teacher, Ms. Jyoti Pandey, for giving a sparkling start to this grand function. How can we forget to thank our art teachers, Mrs. Daljit Kaur Sehra and Mr. Ramesh Kadam, and the battalion of the student volunteers to beautify this event from the entrance to the auditorium. A huge thank you to the teachers of GSMS for their contribution to this event. Special thanks to the Head of Operations, Ms. Niharika De Silva, for her assistance, Mr. Subodh of Stores, and Ms. Tulika, Head of Admin, for her assistance. Thank you to my fellow mates for their collaborative and dedicated efforts to meticulously plan and execute each aspect of this successful event. My special thanks to our technical staff, Mr. Daulat Nalawade and Mrs. Alka Param, for their technical support. A big thank you to the non-teaching staff, Anil, and Class 4 staff members for their support. I express my gratitude to Mr. Radhakrishnan for photography, the social media team, and our decorator, Mr. Sarfaraz and team. Thank you to the electrician for his support. Last but not the least, I sincerely extend my gratitude to our lovely student volunteers for their continuous support. Thank you. Everyone, please stand for the national anthem.
Start right from beginning.
Good morning, respected sir, ma'am, and my dear teachers. My name is Ayan Jain. I studied in senior KGB. My school name is Gopal Sharma Blooming. But today I am going to tell you about two amazing space events, which is the solar and lunar eclipse. There are 8 planets in solar system. Sun is the center of solar system. Earth is the 3rd planet in solar system. Earth moves around the sun and the moon moves around the earth. This is the sun, this is the earth, and this is the moon. A solar eclipse happens when the moon completely comes between the sun and the earth.
Very nice.
This is solar eclipse. Moon blocks sun's light. The day turns into the night for a little while during total solar eclipse. You cannot see solar eclipse directly without any special glasses. You can hurt your eyes. You need to wear special glasses to watch it safely. And the lunar eclipse happens when the Earth comes between the sun and the moon.
Mobile phone
newspaper, batteries, plastic bottles and glass. Recycle. Remember, Harry Small Action make a big difference. Thank you.
3, which was launched on 14 July 2023 and landed on the lunar surface on 23rd August 2023. For the launch of Chandrayaan 3, LVM3 rocket was used. By switching these buttons, the countdown will start and the rocket, after the countdown, will launch into the sky. So I request you, please on the buttons.
Please, switch on the, switch it on,
Where is the rocket going?